in this dark, these woods so deep indeed. I can see, two redfruits lay in front of me. Certainly, certainly, these gifts they must not be. Sent now a present from the gods above. Do you think, if I take them back you will share my smile? Possibly, with this gift, he may cry in joy instead. In the sky, the full moon is so lovely tonight. Hurry up, hurry up, we need to go back because... When walking deep inside the woods at night, the bears can come and give you quite a fright. I have found them after all this ache. I have found them after all my pain. And nobody, no one will ever again take them away from me. I run away through the blooming forest flowers along an endless path. All the while I still hold on to the stolen red fruits. If I cannot make it through, make it home to the one I love, never will we feel the pain of emptiness again. Making a face within the dark, just as I see a frightening shape, I can hear the bear as it's descending on me. I beg of you to overlook my crime, please just let me go to run away. I knew it could not be, for deep down I see that the two stolen fruits were in fact what the bear loved most of all. Once again I'm stumbling, running on and stumbling. I cannot give up something that's so dear to us. By the moon the bear is formed, by the light that can be seen, as the darkest shadow gradually gaining speed. There's no way to turn to now, surely I have lost my way. Even so I have to run, only merely not to run. Now the bear begins to cry, my own tears begin to fall, but the fruits I held with me were crying most of all. My home, sweet home, in the end I am safe and sound when I arrive. Smile at me from where he stands across the room. But when his eyes fall upon what I held in my two arms, no longer smiling, he said to me with a shaken face, "Listen to me, you are far too gone and dreaming tonight a fantasy. Our children are gone and buried in the ground. So the two babies here that you have found have got to be brought back right now to whoever their real mother is." Now even if reality someday had been known to me, with its fangs and claws tearing me then apart, small and warm these tender fruits filled up my deep emptiness. No matter what I had wanted them, God forgive me, for I have sinned with my very own hands, and I know there's no way I can ever take it back. It can be fixed if you hurry now and go, even as I heard him saying so. No, I can't. It's too late. Because outside our home, there now lies her still warm corpse. What was once a woman lays there under the bright moon. A basket on the floor has tilt open next to her, with a bottle full